We started to know when we were producing Brass Unbound. And it actually was a neighbor of me, Rob Boonzaaier Vlaas, who had a subject and he couldn't film it, make the film himself. So he asked my opinion and I said, well, why not Johan van der Keuken? Actually, I didn't know him personally. Of course, I knew his work. Of course, I was very interested in making documentaries and film. But at that time, I was a game show producer, entertainment producer.
For television?
For television. And when I met him in his house, they still had a kind of chimney where they had wood in it. There was no central heater or something. And we were sitting there very cozy, drinking tea. The whole meeting, it was just a talk. You didn't use the word meetings with Johan. When we had to talk about this plan on Brass Unbound, it took 2-3 hours. And when I came out, I had the idea as if we knew each other already for a long time. And it was the first time. It was also my first time making a documentary in Africa, in Ghana. And it was great because it was a very small team. It was Johan and of course Nosh who did the sound and me who trying to...
You were there during the shooting?
During the shooting I was constantly there and actually I was most of the films I did with Johan, I was there. So you have to imagine that the producer is also the driver and the one who takes care of the food and trying to get the children quiet who are always around it if you are filming in Africa. Sometimes he was filming things and I could not oversee what he was doing. I mean, it was so simple, but I couldn't imagine the scene. And in, or he was saying once we were in Burkina Faso, in Ouagadougou, and then you see on the streets that a lot of women are there on a motorcycle, on a scooter. And he saw all these women on scooters, you know, sitting very tight. And he felt the pride of those women. And he said, this morning we're going to film women on scooters. And the whole day I was with the car, slower, faster, big track, you know, shouting, but also fun and excitement. And I thought, what kind of scene will this be? And then you will see the scene in The Long Holiday, and where you see the pride and the joy of women going to their work. And then I said, oh, that was he was doing. But it is, producing is very simple at the end. You have to get the camera on one place and keep the director very safe. Yeah, I can say with any exaggeration that he became a master of for me. And I often now, I think 30 years later, no, 25 years later, I still refer him to his work, to young filmmakers. I produce now a lot of documentaries. And I always come back to his approach and his freedom and his joy of making it. I learned producing by him. Because, as I just said about this simple approach of filmmaking, it became a kind of logic for me how to produce. I sometimes still say, keep it simple. Be at the camera. Be at the place. Don't make it too complicated. At the end, it is that I have a camera and I have to shoot you.